SST College of Arts and Commerce. This is SST Edupedia and myself Assistant Professor Varsha Bharti, and the subject is Advertising and Marketing Research. The topic is Fundamentals of Research. Now let us understand what is research and the definition of it. The Oxford Dictionary defines research as the systematic investigation into the study of materials and sources to establish facts and new conclusions. Now let us understand what is research. Starting from it, the first point which we need to know when we are conducting a research is the research starts with a problem or a question. It is nothing but a systematic study, and we need to follow a scientific method to conduct the research. Now let us understand what are the objectives of research. Why are we conducting a research? To find out truth which is hidden and which has not been discovered yet. Each research has its own specific purpose. Like I said, I will explain you this in this slide. Whenever we are conducting an exploratory research, we need to gain familiarity with the phenomena or to achieve new insights. Now, if we are doing descriptive research, the objective of this research should be portraying the characteristics of a particular individual and situation or a group. Now, further are few examples. Like I said, the purpose of every research is different, so each research has its own purpose. Next is stages in research process. We have different 11 stages in the research. While we are conducting the research, the first stage in the research is formulating the research problem. Second is objectives of the research. Third is hypothesis development. Next is extensive literature review. And the next is choice of research. Let's understand what is the next step. That is designing the data collection form, determining sources of data, determining sampling size, sampling design, and then the next step is to organize and conduct the field survey. Later on, we need to process and analyze the collecting data, and the last stage in our research is to prepare a research report. Now I will explain you the first step in our research is formulating the research problem. The problems which we face and then we conduct the research are, there are three categories in it. The first is overt difficulties. Such situations are quite apparent and visible and obvious. For example, I will give you an easy example, that is failing sales of a retail store which has been declining for quite some time. Now this example is very visible to us that the sales of the store is declining day by day. Next is latent difficulties. The example here which I can give you is, first the sales were declining, but I can say is when the latent difficulties is faced, situations which are not apparent but if not attended to can become a overt after a certain period of time. Like I said, पहले वो जो difficulties होती है वो latent difficulties होती है, later वो overt difficulties बन जाती है. पहले अगर हम लोगों ने example, अगर हम लोगों ने salesman का absenteeism पर ध्यान नहीं दिया, later on it will convert into a difficulty, that is overt difficulty, और उसकी sales कम हो जाएगी. Next is unnoticed opportunities. Now let us understand what are unnoticed opportunities. It means any area of marketing where the growth opportunities exist, such as opportunities are untapped and offer tremendous scope for research. इसमें ये explain करना चाह रही हूँ मैं कि जो भी opportunities unnoticed है वो ही हमारे business के लिए काफ़ी लाभदायक साबित हो सकती है. Next is a complete problem defining must specify the following. If we are formulating a problem for the research, we need to define the problem very well so then the conclusion is clear, the objectives are gained in the conclusion of the report. First is unit of analysis. Whenever we are conducting a research, first of all we need to do is we need to understand and we need to learn every characteristics about the individual or a company or an object which has to be studied under research is known as unit of analysis. Next is characteristics of interest. First of all, unit of interest, now I can give you this example. Whenever a lady is going, if a lady is going to buy a cloth from a clothing store, उसका buying behavior हम लोगों को notice करना है. उसके क्या likings है, क्या dislikings है, वो आएगा unit of analysis. If I am talking about characteristics of interest, then I am saying what all clothing she is interested in. If I am talking about monsoon season, तो वो monsoon season के हिसाब से कपड़े खरीदेंगी. If I am talking about summer season, तो वो summer season के हिसाब से हल्के कपड़े खरीदेंगी. Next is time and space boundaries. Means the period for which the research is conducted. Like I said, period of time. कौन से month में, कौन से time पे हम लोग research conduct कर रहे हैं या buying behavior उनका हमको देखना है. नेक्स्ट इज एनवायरमेंटल कंडीशंस. लाइक आई सेड, एनवायरमेंटल कंडीशंस इंटरनल भी हो सकती है और एक्सटर्नल्स भी हो सकती है. ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ द रिसर्च. द सेकेंड स्टेज ऑफ कंडक्टिंग अ रिसर्च इज वी नीड टू सेट सर्टन ऑब्जेक्टिव्स, देन ओनली कंक्लूजन विल बी परफेक्ट एंड क्लियर. फर्स्ट इज वी नीड टू एक्सप्लेन द एम्स दैट द रिसर्चर इंटेंड्स टू अचीव थ्रू द रिसर्च. नेक्स्ट इज स्पेसिफाइंग वॉट द रिसर्चर इज गोइंग टू डू इन द रिसर्च. This is nothing but objectives of the research. Next, we need to do is hypothesis development. This is the third stage in the research. Hypothesis is a proposition put for verification, which may be right or wrong. The hypothesis which we have developed can be right and as well as it can be wrong. We need to test the hypothesis. The fourth stage, that is extensive literature review. Extensive literature review is nothing but collecting all the literature that is on website or on journals or on magazine or on news. Anything, any written format is considered as literature part. So, researcher must learn more about the topic under investigation. Reviewing the literature related to the research problem, we need to review the literature which is available for us or any other researcher has already done the research in the past. This provides foundational knowledge about the problem area and this educates the researcher about what studies have been conducted in the past and conclusions to it. Like I mentioned earlier, every research may not be done earlier, but there are few researches who have been conducted in earlier period of time. We need to review that research and then later on it will be easier for us to conduct the research. Next is writing steps for writing a literature review. First is defining the problem. We need to narrate the problem in broad and not in a narrow way. Next is deciding the scope for research. How much time will it be covering? Next is making a list of books and websites. What all books and what all websites you will go through? We need to make a list of it. Writing down the literature review, the main and important point is mentioning the author's detail in this stage. Reviewing the literature and reviewing the work done, we need to cross-verify the duplications and any mistakes done in the literature review. The next stage is choice of research design. We have different choices of research. For example, if you are taking exploratory research or descriptive research or casual research, these are nothing but types of researches. We have many choices of research. We need to see which type of research will be beneficial for our research. Like I said, exploratory research, it is based on discovering of new ideas and is generally based on secondary data. Talking about the descriptive research, it is undertaken when the researcher wants to know the characteristics or group of people. Third is casual research. In this research, we are doing nothing but we are understanding the casual relationship between two variables, that is a cause and effect relationship. Next stage in our research is determining sources of data. Now, why do we determine the sources of data? The data which we are collecting should be credible and it should contain all the factual information. The researcher decides which source of data he or she must be using depending on the requirement of the research problem. Various sources of secondary data are investigated. Only when secondary data is unavailable, research should venture into primary data. Now, why the third point is saying that the researcher should venture into primary data is because secondary data is something that is collected earlier and we can use that for our research. But talking about the primary data, we need to collect that data our own self by conducting surveys, interviews. There are two types of sources of data. First is primary and secondary. Now let us understand what is primary data and secondary data. Primary data refers to the first-hand data gathered by researcher himself. Like I said, examples, observations, surveys, experiments, questionnaires, focus groups, interviews, etc. But when we are talking about secondary data, that data is already collected by someone. For example, books, journals, articles, websites and blogs, etc. Now, we need to understand designing the data collection form. How are we supposed to design the data collected? There are two types. First is observation method and second is survey method. Observation method, data is collected through researcher's observation. We need to observe the object or a subject which we are using as a participant in our research. The data can be collected directly by observing the respondents. Survey method. Ways of conducting survey is nothing but personal survey, telephonic survey, email survey or diary. It is necessary to design a good questionnaire for conducting a survey method. Next is determining sampling design and sampling size. Now this is very crucial part in our research. We need to design a good sample size and a good sampling design. Sample will be our number of participants which are participating as our group of people for conducting research. Sampling plan is important because it is impossible to collect data from all respondents. Let's take an example of a classroom. If I have students of number of 30 in my classroom and I need to conduct a survey on my teaching skills, then I will ask a bunch of people, a bunch of students, and I'll do the survey asking them about the questionnaire regarding to my teaching skills, and the report which I am getting and the report which I am making later on conducting the survey would be the Let's take an example of a classroom. In a classroom there are students 30 in number. Agar main 30 logon se apna survey conduct nahi kar sakti, so what I will do is I will ask handful of my students and I will conduct the survey. Now that number of people will be my sample size and they will represent the whole class, that is number of 30 students. Let's talk about sample size. Size of the sample is decided by using practical and statistical approach. So practical is nothing but using practical approach which is very feasible and convenient to us, and statistical approach is using numbers. Sample size. Regardless of the specific technique used in the large sampling steps, they consist of, first is identification of the problem. We need identification of the population, determining the required sample size, selection of participants and data collection. Now we need to organize and conduct the field survey. For that, questionnaire is made and survey is conducted. Field work is supervised to ensure the data is collected accurately. The data which we are collecting in research should be accurate, should be credible. Next point, next stage in our research is processing and analyzing the data. We need to analyze the data which we have collected, be it by secondary source or be it by primary source. Preparing number of tables to give meaning to data collected, then analyzing the data thoroughly. Now the last step in our research is preparing the research report. After analyzing the data, research report is prepared. Using charts and diagrams makes it more easier and easy to interpret the data. Research report must clearly put across the data that researcher has discovered. Now, research report is nothing but making a report of all the things which we have understood in our research, and we need to note down everything which we have collected as a data. The next point in fundamentals of research is research problem. It is demarcation of a problem area within a certain context. Who, what, where, and why is the problem solution? Three sources usually contributes to problem identification. They are own experience or the experience of others may be the source of problem supply. Now, when will the problem arrive? The first thing, if I am facing a problem or someone else has told me about that problem. Next is, a second source could be a scientific literature. We can use scientific literature for problem, for creating a research problem. Next is theories. We can use theories, as there are theories which have certain researches to be conducted. पहले के जो भी research, पहले के जो भी theories किए हुए हैं उन पर research conduct होती है. क्यों theories आए, कैसे वो theories useful है हमको, and further in future वो कैसे काम आने वाली है, क्या update होना चाहिए वो theories में. The techniques involved in defining a problem is, first, state the problem in general way. जो जैसे भी हमको problem बताना है उसको एक general way में बताना है, एक precise pattern में बताना है, clear words होने चाहिए. Next is understanding the nature of the problem. We need to understand what is the nature, what are the characteristics of the problem. Survey the available literature. Now, before conducting the research, we need to collect all the data and then only we can do the literature review. Next is go to discussion for developing ideas. Developing ideas such as how can we conduct the research, designing part, sampling size part, what all procedures should be followed for conducting the research. Next is rephrase the research problem into working proposition. We need to rephrase the research so that we can work accordingly. Next is qualitative research. We are going to understand what is qualitative research and what is quantitative research. It is primarily exploratory research. It provides insights into setting of a problem and generating new ideas or hypothesis for later quantitative research. Now, what do we understand by qualitative research? Qualitative research is nothing but conducting a research through which we can collect all the data using different methods. Usually the sample size is small in the number. Now, if we are comparing qualitative data and quantitative data is all about numbers and statistics, but we need to make a greater size sampling size in quantitative data in comparison to qualitative data. Qualitative research mein sample size chota hota hai and qualitative data mein research size sample size bada hota hai. It is unstructured or semi-structured, and examples are in-depth interviews and group discussions. Data analysis is non-statistical. जैसे कि मैंने mention किया, जो quantitative data है वो statistics और numberings पे based होती है. Quantitative research. Quantitative research is to quantify data and to generalize results from sample to the population of interest. Sample size large होना जरूरी है. Data collection is done using structured techniques such as questionnaires, telephonic interviews. Quantitative research में जो data collect किया जाता है उसके several methods है. उसमें से कुछ है survey, questionnaires, telephonic interviews. We need to survey a lot of people considering a sample size, making a favorable questionnaire with all the points including it, why are we conducting the research, and all the objectives should be included in that survey. Survey jitna acha hoga utna output acha hoga. Next is quantitative research. It is statistical. Like I said, qualitative statistical nahi hota hai, quantitative statistical hota hai. Outcome is used to recommend a final course of action. जब भी क्वांटिटेटिव रिसर्च का आउटकम मिलता है, वी गेट नंबर्स, कितना परसेंट येस, कितना परसेंट नो, व्हाट ऑल ऑप्शंस वी प्रोवाइड देम इन एमसीक्यूज, गिव अस अ गुड अमाउंट ऑफ रेशियो येस बिटवीन येस एंड नो. सो दिस इज इट, फंडामेंटल्स ऑफ रिसर्च. वी गॉट टू नो व्हाट इज रिसर्च, स्टेजेस इन रिसर्च, रिसर्च प्रॉब्लम, डिफाइनिंग अ रिसर्च प्रॉब्लम, एंड देन लेटर ऑन व्हाट इज क्वालिटेटिव डेटा एंड व्हाट इज क्वालिटेटिव रिसर्च एंड क्वांटिटेटिव रिसर्च. दैट इज इट. थैंक यू.